the kitchen this morning with a sweet treat that is perfect for this weekend, which is really, you know, the unofficial start of summer. And what doesn't say summer more than ice cream? So Susanna's here from Susanna's Ice Cream. First of all, where are you located?
We're at Sweetberry Farm in Middletown, Rhode Island.
And there's something about her ice cream that is just so, it's so fresh, and the flavors are, you know, everything's homemade, so it just tastes that much better.
That's right. We start everything from scratch. Most of the flavors are made with a French custard base, mm-hmm. using eggs, and the very freshest cream you can imagine. This comes from Aruda's Dairy in Tiverton.
Great, yeah, and local.
Very local and very fresh and not ultra-pasteurized, which I think makes a difference to the taste. It makes it much fresher tasting.
So that's the base of our ice cream. And then, of course, we have to add some really great flavors. And today, it's a Rhode Island favorite. It's coffee.
Coffee beans from Custom Coffee House in Middletown. Mm-hmm. Great beans.
And then what else do we need for that?
We need sugar, we need some vanilla extract, mm-hmm. and we need some nice fresh eggs. And really, that's about it. It's the simplest thing possible. I try and keep it to the minimum number of ingredients,
yeah.
and nothing with a peculiar name that you can't spell.
I like that even more. It means it's healthy. You know exactly what you're putting into your body. And you are here for another very important reason. Not only do we love her ice cream, but a lot of people across the nation love it. Why?
Well, so it turns out, we got mentioned this year, just came out this week, on a website called Thrill List, which lists what they claim to be the 33 best ice cream shops in the nation. And we're on there with some very illustrious company like Humphrey Slocum.
Awesome.
in San Francisco. And
but
I feel very
so.
Honored.
Rightfully so, because she has some of the best, and we're going to get started in just a bit.
Into the kitchen. Will, how's that ice cream coming?
Let me tell you, you're thinking long holiday weekend, what to do, who doesn't love ice cream? Susanna Williams is here. Susanna Ice Cream, and we are making coffee ice cream.
Coffee ice cream.
That's what's on the menu. Rhode Island's favorite. You got some going over here.
I've got one batch going over here because the whole process is quite lengthy for this ice cream. You need to let the coffee beans steep in the cream for about 30 minutes during the, there's a little cooking before that, there's a little cooking after that. So I've got two batches going so that we get to see the whole process.
So let me tell you, you're not fooling around. I mean, there's no like syrup or anything else in there. You are actually using real coffee beans, and that's
oh,
why you probably,
I am.
Yeah, that's why your
right.
ice cream is so good.
Well, it's, thank you. Let's start adding the ingredients to this, and
all
you'll
right.
see how it works.
Okay.
First, we've got 2 cups of this lovely, thick, heavy cream from Aruda's Dairy in Tiverton.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to measure 1 cup of half and half. You
okay.
want two-thirds half and two-thirds heavy cream to 1 cup of half and half, just okay. to cut the fat content just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
There we go. That does that. Then I already have measured here, 3/4 cup of sugar.
Mm-hmm.
You need quite a lot of sugar in ice cream because when it's frozen and it hits your taste buds, you don't actually taste the sweetness quite as much as you would if it was room temperature.
Oh, so really?
You,
okay.
One of the tricks is to put slightly more sugar in than you think is a good idea.
Okay.
You get it to the point where you think, oh, I've overdone it, and then it's going to be exactly right once it's frozen.
Got it.
Here are the coffee beans.
And they're whole coffee
they
beans.
They are whole, fresh-roasted coffee beans. That's 6 tablespoons of coffee beans.
Right.
A lot of coffee recipes ask you, coffee ice cream recipes say to grind the beans, but I don't think that's necessary,
mm-hmm.
And it makes it much harder to get the... It's awful to have gritty bits in your ice cream.
You don't want gritty bits.
So this makes it easy. It also means that the ice cream comes out a very pale kind of beige color. And I do have people...
We're going to put this together. The ice cream has made a list that's all across the country is one of the best ice creams in the country. If you haven't tried it, you're going to want to try it. We're going to talk about it a little more. We're going to put this together. And yes, we are going to taste the ice cream. That's why we have her here. Back to you. Who doesn't love ice cream on a long weekend? Well, Susanna's ice cream is here. Coffee ice cream is what we're making. Her ice cream location has made Thrill List one of the top 30 best ice creams in the country. Congratulations.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
That's
Thank
great
you
stuff.
Very much.
That's great stuff. We're making coffee ice cream on the what you're putting together today.
Mm-hmm. I am. And this was the one that we put the ingredients together in the first segment.
Okay.
And I'm actually going to put this over to the side for now and
okay.
bring in there's probably a technical name for this, but I don't know what it is. The one I started earlier. Mm-hmm. Here's one I prepared earlier. Because what you need to do is to, having put the ingredients together, the first set of ingredients, is to bring it up to about 200 degrees Fahrenheit, which you can tell more or less visually because it starts to get kind of foamy around the coffee beans. And then you turn that off, you turn off the heat, and you leave it to steep for about 30 minutes with the coffee beans in it. That's what's really going to give it the flavor.
It looks like it's thickened a bit.
A little bit, yes. I made this one a bit earlier. It may possibly have thickened a little bit more than it was meant to, but that's okay.
We don't know.
We don't care.
There's a bit of leeway in this, and the 30 minutes is fairly nominal. You know, if you get distracted and it's 40 minutes, mm-hmm. it's not going
to
make
fine.
A great
that's
deal
good
of
to
difference.
Know.
Yes. Now, at that point, you are going to add the eggs. And mm-hmm. here are our 6 egg yolks, which we will muddle together with a whisk.
Yolks.
Just the yolks, yes. You do not want the whites. Now, the problem with this is that the egg yolks, of course, are cold and this is hot.
Mm-hmm.
So the way to deal with that is to take a few spoonfuls. This isn't the best spoon for that, actually.
Would you like a...
This tablespoon will do fine. Trying to avoid the coffee beans. You want to leave the coffee beans in the mix. Well, it doesn't really make any difference. There goes a coffee bean. It's all right. It's all
just
going
fried.
Back in the same place.
Same place.
In
you know
the
what?
End.
It's Friday.
Exactly.
Let a coffee bean or two go.
I'm going to tell you.
Coffee beans, the better on a Friday.
I don't care what you do with this ice cream. I'm going to have it.
Well, here it is. What this process does is to just warm the egg yolks a little bit so that they don't have
cook.
A fit when they hit the hot mixture.
Because they could cook, right?
They could cook, exactly. You don't want scrambled eggs. And in fact, I'm doing this the dangerous way, which is really the way you would do it
at home.
I'm living on the edge here, doing this in directly on the heat. When I'm making 2 gallons of ice cream at a time at the farm, I'm using a big double boiler.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And that, if you have a double boiler, that's really the way to go with this.
That would be ideal.
Because you don't... that way, as long as you don't let the double boiler run out of water in the bottom, you really can't overcook it. It won't scramble.
Okay.
Now, I have had my adventures with making 2 gallons of ginger-flavored butter, which, you know, is, there are limited uses for when
Can
it comes
right
down
to it. Can I tell
you
right how much we love you? I'm professing my love to you on television.
I'll tell you what.
Thank you, Matt.
Just letting you know. I don't care who's watching.
Oh, man.
So now you want to stir this. Here's the exciting part. You're stirring this until it reaches one. You can do it by eye. Mm. You can do it with. I have a very fancy thermometer here, which you don't Whoa. Really need for a small batch. But this again
but it's
goes.
Cool.
What's the temperature, isn't it?
The temperature that you need is about 175 Fahrenheit. At that point, you have pasteurized all your ingredients, which, if you're using fresh eggs, is a really good idea.
Mm-hmm.
In the commercial version, I'm using pre-pasteurized egg yolks.
Mm-hmm.
With real eggs, pasteurizing the eggs is a really good plan. So I'm bringing this up to 175, and that also means that the eggs
We're
are going to
there.
Thicken, and that, we need to crank the heat a little,
mm-hmm.
That also means that you're going to, that the eggs will just thicken enough to provide the thickening for the ice cream, because since I'm not using any of those fancy schmancy,
145?
Yeah, we're getting there. Any of those stabilizers like the xanthan gum that mm-hmm. are used in commercial ice cream, the eggs are what are thickening the ice cream and giving it what is known in the trade as the mouthfeel.
Then from there you'll put it in the ice cream maker.
That's right.
And
yes.
then it comes out like this.
Like this.
That's exactly right.
Coffee ice cream.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. We've got a scooper here. Will, I'm going to give you,
Thank you
a spoonful.
Okay.
You dive into that. I'm going to scoop one for myself. If you want to learn how to make this yourself, I know there was a lot of steps, but you can find them all over on roadshow.com.
Yum.